Well, happy Halloween. This is the first seasonal video that we do. The film that we're going to talk about is Silence of the Lambs. We're going to focus on a special relationship that exists between Crawford, the FBI director, and Clarice, and how they work together. The relationship that they built is one that we'll refer to as the mentor and the mentee. The FBI director, played by Scott Glenn, he's the mentor. Clarice is the mentee. The leader, the one who knows how to do it, is going to show the person how to do the project by going through the process together. We'll cover the responsibilities of the person doing the mentoring, and we'll cover the responsibilities of the person being mentored. They both have to work together for it to be successful.
Jobs come up and I thought about you.
The Scott Glenn character, Inspector Crawford, he had a project to do. He communicated to her very clearly what the project was.
We're interviewing all the serial killers now in custody for a psychobehavioral profile. See, the one we want most refuses to cooperate. I want you to go after him again today in the asylum.
Who's the subject?
The psychiatrist, Hannibal Lecter.
He communicated to her what her role was going to be and what his role was going to be.
So if he won't cooperate, I want just straight reporting.
You don't just have one conversation and then say, you got it? No, it's a, we're going to start this, and then what we're going to start here is a conversation throughout the project. And throughout the project, you're going to talk to me, I'm going to talk to you. You don't disappear, I don't disappear.
Have your memo on my desk by 0800 Wednesday. I want your full attention, Starling.
Yes, sir.
The second thing he does is that he initiates conversations with her on a regular basis.
Clarice, phone, it's the guru.
Crawford? Thanks, Cordelia.
Starling?
Sir?
That fosters and gives the mentee the example that, okay, this person likes to talk a lot. There's not a, hey, what's up? There's not a lot of silence. And the third thing he does, he gets involved with her. He gives her tasks for her to do. He also does some things behind the scenes that he's got to do on his own because he's not wanting to put everything on her. The responsibility of the person being mentored is that they have to be hungry.
While you could only dream of getting out, getting anywhere, getting all the way to the FBI.
They have to be ambitious. They really got to take risks and move things forward. There's a scene in which she has to clear out the room and she takes a risk and she clears the room out.
Excuse me. Her folks would thank you if they could for your kindness and your sensitivity. And now please, go on now, let us take care of her. Go on now.
Right there is when most of the managers see that and go, okay, oh no, the mentee is creating an awkward situation. No, there's a point in which you have to let the mentee take a risk, but the mentor did not slap her wrist. And that's important because if you control everything and you don't let your mentee take some of that risk, that person's gonna back off. The second thing that the person being mentored has to bring to the table, a high degree of coachability. They have to be very humble.
Starling, we know who he is and where he is. We're on our way right now.
Be on the ground in 45 minutes with HRT.
The mentor actually did things to go and try to arrest the murder suspect and he didn't tell her. It's very easy right there for the person being mentored to take offense and go, hey, no. I got to be able to coach you at my discretion.
Well, Chicago's only 400 miles from here. I'll be there and...
I need you to link him to Bimmel Girl before he's indicted. See what you can dredge up in Belvedere.
Yes, sir. You bet.
Notice how she reacted. She moved into, how can I help?
Starling, we wouldn't have found him without you. Nobody's going to forget that.
I will make sure everyone knows, and that calmed her down. The third, what Clarice brings is a high degree of people skills.
There's no one here, Jack. Clarice.
When she's finally facing the suspect, the murder suspect, she reads the situation. As you see her, she's kind of seeing, looking around. Something's not right. She observes him. She watches him. She looks around and then acts. And she moved all around the personality profiles. That is great people skills because if you can be stable when you have to be stable, if you can be data mindful when you need to be, relationship, calming somebody down with a little bit of charm and enthusiasm, and then how to move into action, that right there spells success. And then at the end of it, the great finale is what showed that the relationship was a success. She was part of the recognition And the director gave her a full front stage of being recognized for the incredible work that she did. He decreased so she could increase. The mentor sees that the mentee caught things and that that person will now be successful. And the mentee looks at that other human being and says, wow, there's people like that that exist.
Your father would have been proud today.
It's that human element that makes both the mentor and the mentee extremely happy. I owe so much of what I am and what I do to about 4 or 5 mentors in my life who were there for me and basically said, Clarice, you can do this. The satisfaction that comes from being mentored by someone that cares and the satisfaction of mentoring somebody that's willing to be coached, that is what makes working in the workplace in professional environment so rewarding. Thank you guys for joining us. We'll see you at the movies.